97.3 City FM. Relevant radio, always.
Incompetence is when the government sets a target of 4% budget deficit in 2008 and finishes the year at 15% deficit, missing the target by a massive 11%, and in the process recording the highest budget overrun in our history from 1983. That's incompetence. Incompetence is when the government sets out to build four major road projects called the number four, and that government doesn't even have a clue where the financing is coming from. That's what they call in the Bible, deciding to build a mansion. You don't have a clue where the money is coming from. That's everything for you. Definition of incompetence. Incompetence is when a whole government gets scourged by a phantom IFC company and goes through the global humiliation of chasing non-existent $1 billion loan all the way into a hairdressing salon. That is the definition of incompetence. Incompetence is when the government sets up a whole ministry in charge of railways and still fails to deliver 1 centimeter of railway line. Actually, get us worse, presides over a situation where some of the old lines that were built there before that government came started being sold as crap. That is the definition of incompetence. Incompetence is when a so-called economic group praises the macroeconomic performance during the period of President Bill's, while attacking the same President John Mahama for not having the economy well from 2013 to today, without even realizing that it's the same President John Mahama who was head of the economic management team during the period 2009 to 2012. It is incompetence not to realize that. Incompetence is when the flag bearer who is making claims of being able to transform Ghana was unable to provide even basic potable water to his own constituency, even though he was MP for 12 long years and cabinet member for 7 years. That's the definition of incompetence. Incompetence is when the running mate of that same flag bearer goes round promising to remove taxes on pensions without even knowing that no tax exists on pensions in Ghana. That absolutely is monumental incompetence. Incompetence is when the party fails to appreciate that one cannot simultaneously be opposed to increased taxation and increased borrowing, while at the same time claiming to be able to bring transformation and prosperity to Ghana. It's just not possible. Incompetence is when the government is giving the full details of the location of a cocaine-carrying vessel, but that government was still unable to prevent the vanishing of the cargo of cocaine when that vessel docked on the shores of Ghana. That's incompetence. Incompetence is when the flag bearer at the whole presidential debate says that the answer to maternal mortality is free SHS. That is monumental incompetence. Incompetence is when the running mate to the same flag bearer during the Supreme Court petition was asked the following question: between a figure written on a check and the amount written in words, when you are in doubt, which one should a banker rely on? The shocking answer from him was, when in doubt, you must rely on the figure. He got that wrong. Something any elementary banker knows. The Bill of Exchange Act 7.2 states, and I quote, when in doubt, use amount in words. In fact, one does not need to be a banker to understand this. And this is the man that calls President Mahama incompetent. God have mercy on that. Incompetence is when a government mismanages the economy so badly that it is compelled to sell a precious national asset like Ghana Telecom just so as to survive. At no time between 2009 to 2008 have we, I'm talking NEC, had to resort to the sale of national assets in order to stay afloat. Never. Incompetence is when the government spent 8 years in power, gets 11 times the revenue of the previous government, and 4.3 times the loans of that previous government, but can still not point to one regional hospital, or one public university, or one completed affordable house. That is the definition of incompetence. Incompetence is when the government sleeps on the job and waits until there's energy crisis at the end of 2006 before waking up to start thinking about adding to the national energy pool. That is incompetence. Incompetence is when the government promises to reduce the importation of rice by 1/3. And in 8 years, rather preside over the increase of rice import from $100 million when he met it to $500 million by close to 2005. That is incompetence. Incompetence is when the government in 2008 used precious resources to buy locomotives at a time when not even 1 centimeter of rail line had been constructed. One wonders when they expected the locomotives to ride. Maybe the back of an elephant. Maybe. Incompetence is when NPP increased the duration of SHS without corresponding increase in classrooms to cater for extra numbers of students that were coming on board, and also failed to provide other key facilities that should appreciate the change if quality was not to be jeopardized. Incompetence is how the NPP pursued aggressively the attainment of the single digit inflation and was able to, and was not able to reach it for 8 long years, except for 1 short month. Incompetence is when NPP in its first 4 years could not show evidence of any major road constructed in Ghana. Take a look at the NPP's publication, 4 years of achievement so far so good, and you'll notice shortly that you cannot see, especially here. Take a look at it, you cannot see even 1 major road.
97.3 City FM, Relevant Radio, always.